vocal technique development. The ultimate international screaming vocal school. RMS Vocal Institute.
Hi everyone, Soren here, head teacher at RMS Vocal Institute. I will start a new little video series, four videos. The first video explaining what you should look out for and what you should stay away from to keep a healthy voice. The second video is about what you should be doing to keep that healthy voice. The third video is about what you should be doing before going up on stage and how that day looks like. And the fourth one is about what you should be doing when you record your amazing music with your band and what you should look out for on that day. So here we go. This video is all about what you should be doing to keep that healthy voice of yours. The first thing we need to look into to keep that healthy voice of yours is get those 8 hours of sleep. Please, every single night, there's hormones that's repairing everything inside your voice every single night. It needs that. It's the real rest of your voice. All this people talking about that you need to cool down your voice and so on. Well, if you were singing incorrectly, then yes, a good little extra exercise at the end would be a good thing, but sleep is the number one priority, okay? So get that sleep. Make sure you get good night's sleep. So turn off that TV, turn off your cell phones and all this. You probably heard it before, but it's important. The next thing you need to do to keep that healthy voice of yours,
H2O,
and enough of it. How much, you might ask? Well, you need 1.8 ounces per day or around 2 liters. It's the best way to remember it. If you're one of those who really like your coffee or your tea with a lot of caffeine in, no worries. All you need to think about is every time you get a cup of coffee or tea, then drink the same amount of water. So that's on top of your 2 liters per day. Okay? One of the main reasons that we want to drink a little bit extra water is actually also because of the mucus. We all produce mucus. It is important for our voice. However, you can thin it out a little bit so you don't suddenly have this thing stuck in your throat while singing. So that's a pretty nice little extra thing from H2O. So get it, drink it, love it. The next one is, of course, exercise. Stay in shape, do cardio exercises because you want to be in control over your breath as much as possible. So if you have a, let's say you're the headlining act and you have a 1 hour to 1.5 hour show, can you run for 1 hour or 1.5 hour? Next one, eat and drink exactly what you want. It doesn't matter as long as you're not allergic. It does not come in contact with your vocal folds. If, for example, I drink too much milk, yes, I feel like I don't have any control over anything that's going on. So if you have that type of a sensation, for example, from milk products, then stay away from it. You can eat and drink whatever you want. I really love chili, for example, and I have never had any huge issues with this. And some would say I get a lot of acid from eating too much chilies. Well, then don't do it. You feel out your body and see what you can and cannot do. The only thing we know, academically proven, is that you should stay a little bit away from heavy amounts of garlic and ginger, but it's also healthy for you. So find a balance. Just don't do it too much. That's all. So the ginger honey thing, it's not academic at all. You can find papers on this, so look it up. And of course, always heat up your voice before you use it. Very important. You don't start, let's say that you are a person who loves to go to the gym. You do not start with the 150 or 200 kilo thing. You start with smaller weights, heat up your muscles, make sure everything is going as it should, and then you slowly add some weight to it. It's the same for your voice. Don't start with the heavy exercises. Start from a more calm place and then slowly build up. every day is not the same. Did you get the right amount of sleep, for example, and was it really effective sleep? I, for example, had sleepwalking issues when I was a kid, and I still talk a lot while I'm sleeping. So I can wake up a little bit hoarse, like, and not really, you know how my voice will end up during the day. So make sure you take every day as that day and not think, oh, I was fine yesterday, I was fine the day before. Yes, that's okay, but today is a new day. So heat up your voice, look into what you can and cannot do on that day. Sometimes it needs a little bit more heating up than others. When should we start exercising then? When should I start heating up my voice? Well, you wake up, some say that this frying sound is a part of heating up your voice in the morning and getting it active. Well, that could be very correct. I personally, at least, do not start doing my piano exercises, stretching, strengthening my voice before at least 2 hours after I woke up. I would recommend waiting up until 3 hours. I do this every single day or close to every single day. So that's where you can see that, okay, I should at least wait around 3 hours, then my voice is heated up a lot and ready to do these tasks. I would recommend you do the same. Try one day 2 hours after, then the next day try 3 hours after. If you see the same as I did, that 3 hours is better than two, then wait that extra hour. You could be eating something, you could wake up slowly. So think about it. The next thing is, of course, stretch out your body before heating up your voice. It's a good little thing to do. There is voice yoga exercises out there on YouTube or wherever you want to look. They do help and they do work. So please look into that. You might really enjoy it. It's at least something I do here and there. And I do think that my voice is a little bit easier to work with afterwards. So I'm not saying you have to. I'm saying it's a very good idea. And the final one. Where do you heat up your voice? Are you sitting down or are you standing up? When you're out playing shows, are you sitting down or standing up? It's not the same. Because if you're sitting down, you have approximately 30% less air support, meaning you're practicing your muscle memories to say, oh yeah, that's how I feel when I'm sitting down. And that's what I will then bring to when I'm standing up. Well, you don't need that much extra push. So please organize it in a way so if you are only standing up live, then heat up your voice standing up, or the opposite. If you're actually doing both, then do both, because it is a transition thing then where you have to be able to do both and understand both the things and your muscle memory to understand, okay, now he's sitting down or she's sitting down and standing up instead. So you actually know the difference in your body when doing both. I really, really hope that this helped and this was informative for you. If you liked the video, please push the like button, push the subscribe button, the little bell down there, and stay subscribed for more videos to come. Otherwise, book a lesson with me at rmsvocalinstitute.com and I cannot wait to see you there. Have an amazing day.